I'm delighted to be over here. I'm delighted because I have been born to be a human being, as differentiated from an animal. The animal is very happy if he's secure, if he gets his food, and he's able to have a good night's sleep, if he can progenate and be able to again go back to sleep. He can then look for the next day's meal, eat and be happy, and then go back to sleep. And that's what differentiates a human being from an animal, because he looks much further than just an animal. This is the evolution of the human race as differentiated from the rest of the animals that we could have been born as. That's the difference that makes a human being move to the next level of being able to live a life, not just live as the animal kingdom does. And that is why it is extremely important to understand what is it that makes that difference? What is it that makes the human being different to be able to see the unseen? To be able to visualize something which is extraordinary. And the people who have done it consistently and every day, a few of them we definitely know. Because what did he say? I have a dream. And that's what Nelson Mandela said. And at the time when he said it, the Negroes were segregated from the white man. Martin Luther King brought that thought into the American process and completely changed the future of America. Segregation took place. Nelson Mandela spent 27 years in jail. After that, he was ready to move out of the world and to be able to see what he dreamt 27 years before. That is what he continued to see, and he continued to believe that he would be able to achieve something which nobody could have believed so many years before. You and I can do the same thing. There's no difference between them, except that you have to step and have a dream and visualize what you want to do. 30 years ago, when I taught and I got into the business of real estate, and we were very, very small, I always had a dream that one day I would be a very big developer. One day when I would make multiples of townships that happened. I never really thought that I would be able to achieve it. Today, as we know, I have been successful, not in one township, but multiple townships that have taken place. So it's not just a dream that happened. How did these dreams actually fructify to do so? And it's not very difficult to understand what we need to do as human beings to differentiate ourselves and make our dreams come true. Lots and lots of things have taken place. Last week, I saw a movie which was called Mission Mangal. It talks about the Indian ISRO going to Moon and to Mars. And the stunning part was that a poorer country, as differentiated from the United States and NASA, we had only 15 to 20% of the budget of NASA, the richest country in the world, the United States. However, we have now been able to do it at the cost of 15% of what NASA actually did. It's because India has the dream, in spite of not having the kind of money which the United States has, but still be able to meet that ambition. So the human being in the Indians made that differentiation happen, worked and worked on it, having very little money as compared to the United States, the richest country in the world, and still be able to meet that aspiration more. So when you have a dream, it's not necessary that you will have the wherewithal at the time when you have the dream to be able to reach it. It's only that you have to have the aspiration to think of the dream And to really move in the direction of that dream that we need to do as human beings, as differentiated from any other animal who gets satiated by just having his food. That's what makes us different and beautiful as the thought of human beings and the exception that you and I can now achieve, which an animal cannot even think of looking at that direction. So, I just came last night from a city of Dubai. And when I went over there, I was inquiring from them as to how many tourists, because I saw the airports full, lots of hotels full, and I was wondering how many visitors must be there as tourists to the city of Dubai. And I found out that Dubai has more people. I found out that Dubai is having more visitors landing at Dubai airport than the whole of India. Can you imagine a small city, just one city with a single airport, having more visitors than the whole of India, having so many places to visit and other things? But it is the aspiration of a man called Sheikh Mohammed, which made that difference where one human being could think of and say, I shall dream that I will have more visitors to Dubai than the entire country called India. So why is it not India that can have 100 times more people to have visitors to come to India? And if we have that dream, we can make it happen. So now what's the answer? How do I really achieve these dreams? And many times people ask me, and especially young people, as to what is it that really you start with? And the first is to focus on your dream. Whatever is your dream, focus on it. Think about it. Dream about it. Look about it. Find out who are the mentors who show you the direction to reach your dreams. And once you have that into hand, learn to take the first step. What do you do? Take one step forward towards your dream. The dream may be thousands of steps away. It may be the step of climbing Mount Everest. But remember, the Mount Everest climb also starts with the first step. And it doesn't matter when you decide to start. You can start at 18, 28, 38, 48, 58, 68. Any age whatsoever, as long as you have a beautiful dream, as long as you want to see something which nobody has seen, you can take the first step to actually move towards your dreams. And it's not difficult. Let me give you my own story. At the age of 48, I went to my school, my alma mater, Campion School, and I was to join the old boys of that school at age 48 to run 20 meters. It was a fun race. And we all ran 20 meters. But at the end of 20 meters, I was panting. I was tired. I was exhausted. Because that stage of my life, I had put in so much effort to bring up my business and other things that I really didn't take care of my health. And I was petrified. I was scared. At 48, if that was the stage of my health, what's going to happen when I become 60? And that's the day I decided that I'm going to make a difference to my life. And this is not what is going to be there. I'm going to become much more healthier. And I took the first step to join a gym. And the gym very close to our house, and I started that. It was extremely difficult because I was never used to ever going to a gym. And it didn't make sense in the beginning. But my ultimate objective was that I would be back to become healthy, and not the miserable state of my health that it was at age 48. Let me do a fast forward quickly for you, and let me tell you that I am now only 69. And the difference between age 48 and the steps that I took over a period of years made a huge difference to me, but it was always one step at a time. And what happens today? I gym 3 days a week, regularly in a gym for 1 hour a day. I do yoga 2 days a week, 1 hour a day. And 1 day a week, I run 5 kilometers. And I also do a quarter marathon of 10 kilometers at least twice, if not 3 times a year. So what I couldn't believe at the age of 48, at the age of 69, I had achieved. Obviously, it sounded impossible for me to even dream of it at that point of time because of the kind of health I had at that time and the difference that it had at the time which is taking place today. But I have achieved it. And it's not really difficult. If you have the ultimate goal in your mind, if you remember that you have to keep on taking one step every single day in order to improve what you're doing to achieve your goal, I promise you that you will and shall achieve your goal. There is no reason why you will not. Will there be setbacks? Of course. There is no ambition in the world which doesn't have setbacks. Whether you want to learn to go and climb mountains, you want to reach Mount Everest, you want to do the business of business, you want to do anything that you want to achieve, which is extraordinary at the time when you want to achieve it, yes, you will have setbacks. Did Israel have setbacks? The answer is yes. Did Nelson Mandela have setbacks? Of course. Did Martin Luther King have setbacks? Yes, of course. Everyone has had setbacks in their lives. It is that time that you have to have your thoughts very clear. You have to have your timing very clear and your thoughts extremely clear that you have to keep moving forward to make that achievement. You have to make a movement forward to take your achievement. And when you consistently do that, I promise you, there is nothing in the world which you cannot achieve. Everything is at your doorstep. That is what you really need to do to be able to do it. There are several other tips that I can share with you. One of the tips is that you should be interested in your growth rather than comfort. We all want to be a little lazy. Nothing wrong with that. You need to take a break from whatever you're planning to do. The answer is yes, of course you should. But don't miss out keeping the goal in mind. The moment you keep your goal in mind, you don't mind the pain of whatever it is. Whether you go to the gym, whether you want to work on your business, or you want to work on a project, of course you have the pain to do so. But the pain is fun. The pain and pleasure of that work is different because you really, really want to achieve the end goal of whatever it is you want to do. That's one of the thoughts that has always worked for me. There's another thought that really helps us to achieve such goals, and that is to do something new every single day. Let me give you an example. I'm not a music-oriented person. I love to hear music, yes, but I've never ever played a musical instrument in my life. 3 months ago, I decided that I want to learn a musical instrument and to play a song for my grandson. And I decided that on November, when it's his birthday, I will be able to play a musical instrument for my grandson. My wife thought I was stupid because she knows that I am totally not conversant with any musical instrument. Anyway, I bought myself an organ and I got myself a teacher. Very difficult because I'm not musically oriented. And I promise you, today I can play Happy Birthday on the piano. And that has been extremely difficult for me because I have never learned a musical instrument earlier in my whole life. But I can do it at age 69 just because I thought that I can dream myself playing Happy Birthday for my grandson who will be 2 years old in November of this year. So it doesn't matter if it's a great mission in your life. It doesn't matter if it's business. It doesn't matter if it's a scholastic aptitude. It doesn't matter what the objective is. It is a little small thing like learning the piano and playing a happy birthday for your grandchild. It doesn't really matter what you really aspire to do. As long as you can dream the undreamable, unbelievable, something beyond which is normally not done by you, and you take the first step forward, be willing to accept the pains and pleasures of whatever you have to go through for the purposes of achieving these targets, that's the way to go as far as that is concerned. And the other aspect of it is always to look for mentors. And this is something I learned very early in my life. When I wanted to do townships and other things, at that point of time, I was told that Singapore was putting up many new townships and creating all these. And this is a story of almost 25 to 30 years ago. So I went to Singapore and studied what they do in terms of townships and other things. And I learned ideas. We don't copy them. The mentor is not meant to be copied. He becomes a source of inspiration of what it is. And you pick up thoughts and ideas which you need to inculcate into what you want to do. So yes, you must have plenty of mentors. You have mentors which may be on scientific endeavor. It may be mentors who change the quality of your life. They may be spiritual leaders who will lead you into your life. So you will have different mentors at different points of life to reach the levels of life that you have never seen before. That's the most beautiful thing, that you need to pick up ideas and thoughts, sometimes from books, sometimes from other ways of learning, otherwise from leaders whom you can look up to in different ways of life. And then there is one handicap that we all live with, and that is to give up. I also gave up many times. Whether it was doing my business of townships to make it beautiful, or it was learning the piano last month, all these were extremely difficult for me to do. All were very difficult to do. But at that point of time, you have to see that you are able to overcome on it. And the moment you take the steps to overcome it first time, it will always happen. The problem is how you manage not to overcome the first time. That is a difficult part of it. And you don't give up that mission. If you pick up all these great ideas and aspire to reach the moon, aspire to see the unseen, look forward to do something brand new in any endeavor of your life, in personal capacity, in terms of your health, in aspirations for your business, anything at all that the human mind can dream of, aspire to reach the moon. Think of doing that great difference. And my friends, let me give you the best example as a conclusion. The best example that I can give you is of Prime Minister Narendra Modi. The man just started his life as a chai wala. What could he aspire for? He would only be a better chai wala. At the most, the chai wala could have been a restaurant owner or a hotel owner. That's all this man could aspire for. But no, he thought of it differently. Prime Minister Narendra Modi thought of moving up, changing this country, aspiring, moved to become the leader, became the chief minister of Gujarat, moved on to aspirations of nationhood. What a beautiful example of being able to see the unseen. Never before has a chai wala aspired to be a prime minister. Today, he is now going to be a global leader, being recognized by one and all. My friends, you too can be a global leader, a leader of sorts which can make the unseen seen, aspire for anything in your life. And I promise you, if you as a human mind shall be able to achieve it. I wish you, each and every one of you, the best of luck and best wishes for meeting and making all your dreams come true. All the very best.